Okay, everyone. So now we are creating a program where we will use the timer control. And with the help of this timer control, we will create an application. This Windows application will be for the traffic light, where the traffic light will come and go based upon the timer. So first of all, we are going to drag and drop few text boxes. So this is first text box, then second, and third. So three text boxes we have taken. Now we want that these three text boxes should be acting like the light. So I'm going on the form load coding. I'm double clicking on the form. Here I am representing that whenever form will be loaded, at that time these three text boxes should be having their color. So I'm mentioning that text box one dot back color. We know that there are three traffic lights. One is the red. So we are mentioning that color dot red. So here the red color we have taken. Then in the text box 2 dot back color, we are providing color dot yellow. So this is our second light. Now we are creating the third light, which is text box 3 dot back color. That is equal to color dot green. So these are the three lights we have created. Now we are executing this code. So afterward we can see that these are the three lights which are present. Now we are going back to the form. Now here we want that these all text boxes should be enabled or visible right now. So by default they are visible, so we don't have to do anything. Now afterward we are going back and providing it the shape. So we are providing it as a shape. Now afterward we want a button. We want that whenever we click on the button, at that time they just start with the moving. So now here we are mentioning that the name of button is, let's say, start. So when we click on the start, then afterward these lights will keep on blinking one after the another using the timer. So this is the start button. Now we can even extend these LED lights. So I am providing the new shape here. I am extending them. So here we are extending all the lights which are available. Afterward, if you want that this start button should come in between, we can take it. You can provide your name to the code. Let's say I'm providing my name here. Now afterward we are going back and running this and we'll see how it will look like. So this is how the program will look like. I'm extending a little more. Now afterward I'm providing them the central line. So here I'm putting them center. Now here is the time to take the timer control. So we have to go on the left hand side in the toolbox and finding for the timer control. So here we are having the timer. We are dragging and dropping this timer into the form, but you can see that it is not onto the form, it is onto the bottom line. That means this timer will work on the back end. Timer do not be onto the form, it work on the back end. That's why it is not on the form, it is on the back end. Now double click on the timer. There is a code for the timer which is already available. You can see that it is private sub timer underscore tick. Tick means every click. So every minute second is going to increase, and at that time timer will increment. So we are taking a variable here which is static. Static because its value will be remain available. Static t as integer. So one variable we have taken static. Because whenever we are going to call this timer, then afterward their value will be remain same. So static will hold the value. So select case, and we are applying this case on T. We want that there should be three categories. On every category, one light should be displayed. 1, 2, and 3. These are HTML text boxes. So after every case, one text box should be available. Let's say I am using the case 1. In the case 1, we want that only text box 1 should be displayed. So I am making that text box 1 dot visible is equal to true. So only first text box will come. Other text boxes, just like text box 2 and text box 3, should be visible false. That means only one text box will be visible. That means only one light is coming. So here we are mentioning that text box 3 dot visible equal to false. So here we can see that only one text box, or that means one light, is available. So this is true, other lights are false. So we are using another case also, case 2, and case 3. So three cases we have implemented here. Now we are going to just copy this code and pasting to the case 2 and case 3. We want that in the case 2, the second light should be true. So here this light should be visible, then other will be false. So here we made that is false. Similarly, we want that in the case 3, the text box 3 should be true and other will be false. So this is how we have created the code. Now here we should provide an interval. Interval means, because it is a timer, after how long you want that your first light should come. So here we providing, let's say we are entering here. Now we are mentioning timer 1, because timer 1 we have taken dot interval. Interval means, what is the time duration? Let's say I am saying 200. This is the time duration. Similarly, so it is timer 1 dot interval is equal to, here I am providing, let's say 250. So it is totally up to you how much you are providing. Now again, we are using the timer 1 dot interval, that is equal to, let's say I am providing 300. So these are the three we have given. Now afterward, we want that whenever once this timer is executed at the last stage, it should be like stop. So we are saying that here, timer 1 dot stop. So timer 1 will stop after the third light. And who is going to run this case? After running every case, we want that there should be the increment in t value. So we are mentioning that t is equal to t plus 1. So once the first case will run, afterward it will increment, second case will run, then third case will run. This is how cases will run. And who is going to start the timer? This is the start button, who will start the timer. So double click on that. Here we are mentioning that timer 1 dot start. So here we are going to start the timer. Now we are going to see that how this program will look like. So we are going on the run. After, you can see that there are three lights which are available. Now how these three lights are coming? When the form is loaded, this code will work. Text box 1 is having the red color, text box 2 is having the yellow, and text box 3 is having the green color. So this is the first case. Now afterward, I am going to click on the start button. So we know that whenever we click on the start button, what is going to happen? This timer will start. So here we are having the coding of button. If I click on the button, here we can see that these are the three text boxes which are coming one after the another. Now how this code is working? If I click on the start, then this start timer will start. Then afterward, we are just going back. Then this is the code. Right now, when we click on the start button, then a t variable is declared, and right now its value will be 0. Now no case will work, so t will be incremented, then t will be 1. Then afterward, case 1 will run. In that case, there is a 200 milliseconds of the gap. Then afterward, text box 1 will appear, then other text box will be false. Then it will come out, t will increment going on the 2. Then similarly, it is going to have the interval of 250. Text box 1 and 3 will be false, 2 will work. Then afterward come out, t will increment, it will be 3. Then case 3 will work. Here after the interval of 300 milliseconds, then here first and second text box will false, it is not visible. Then 3 is visible and timer will stop. Now if you want that, there should be a loop. Loop means it should be keep on going, it should never stop. So you can take one more button here. So we are stopping this program and going back to the code. We want that timer should not stop like this. There should be something different. So we are going to the toolbox, and from there we are taking a button, and this button we will take for stopping the timer. So here we are taking a button and we are mentioning stop here. So this is the button of stop. We are aligning this as per same required. On this button, we are mentioning that timer 1 dot stop. So once we click on the button, then timer will stop. Now here we are going back and just removing it. But you understand that when the timer will start from this button, it will keep on incrementing. The value of t will be how much? 3, and timer will stop here. So once the case will be 3, we want that the value of t will become again 0. Because when it will come out, Again, it is one and keep on moving. So now we are running this code. So here we are having this program. Now you're going to see that how this code will work. Right now we can see that the form is loaded when we click on this play button. Then these text box 1, 2, and 3 are red, yellow, and green. Then after we click on the start. So once we click on the start button, we know that timer will start. So here, start. You can see that timer is starting. Now how does keep on moving? Now we are going back to the code and we will see how the timer code is working. Now this is keep on moving. Once the timer will start, at that time a static t variable is declared. Right now the value of t is 0. We know that any variable declared in .NET will be having the value 0. No case will run for that. T incremented to 1. Going back. Now here static will hold the previous value. So here 1. Case 1 will run after 200 milliseconds of the gap. Text box 1 here, the red will be displayed, other are false. So once the red is available, other are false. Going afterward, t incremented to 2, case 2 will run only. Now here after 250 milliseconds of the interval, the text box 1 and 3 are false and 2 is available. So 2 means yellow. So yellow is available and other are false. Similarly, it is going out and t incremented to 3. Now case 3 will work, and on the case 3, after 300 milliseconds of the gap, here 1 and 2 will be false. So once the green is coming, 1 and 2 text boxes are false, and third green is coming. Once the green will come, that means text box 3 will come, case 3 is running, it is making to t0. Once t is 0, again it will be incremented to 1. So again start from 1, 2, 3, again 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. So this is how it is moving. 1, 2, 3 and T0 again, 1, 2, 3. So this is how. And here we are having the coding of stop. So once we are clicking on the stop, then timer will stop and it will be on hold. If you want that, it should start. So click on the start. It is keep on working afterward. And if you want that, there should be some more gap available. Then you can simply go back and increase some of the value. Let's say you are representing some value here. Then afterward, you are again running this code and you are going on the start. Here you can see that now it will come later on after some time. So this is how, if you want, there should be some delay, more delay you want to add. So here is the interval you have to provide it. So this is how we can take the timer into our code, and with the help of timer we can use various things, like we can take an exam, we can provide some quiz. We simply design some button. We just say that whenever user start, after a certain time, this code will execute. So this is how the timer can be included. So that is the code of timer.